primary education and higher education is one of the key commitments he has made during his first term as governor. And while we can agree or disagree with regard to the tax increases or not, Congressman Casey is advocating eliminating the income tax in total. One cannot make any investments in primary or secondary education and also eliminate the income tax. We will focus on our areas that we've proven to the state of Ohio, that we've kept our commitments, and we'll compare those areas to John Kasich's concerns and whether or not his ideas would do damage to our state going forward. And we'll let the people of the state decide. Ken Blackwell had a very similar idea as it related to the income tax code. He wanted to lessen all obligations across the board, and in large part, do away with some of those obligations. The end result is that police and fire men and women would lose their jobs. The end result, the first responders would not have the kind of abilities that they have now with this government. The end result is that the impact on social services would make these days that we're going through now look like something that we had wished we could go through yet again. John Kasich's ideas compared to Governor Strickland's ideas are wide and very distinct, and we'll point those out to people of the state over the course of the next 14, 15 minutes.
What's some of the input that you have in the budget discussions and specifically on the education?
I had none.
Zero?
Zero.
Zero discussions with any?
I did not speak to the governor. I had no discussion with the governor nor any of the staff with regard to whether or not VLTs should or should not be implemented. I spoke when spoken to, and actually I never put a phone on, I was waiting for the call. I speak about the political impact that our decisions make, whether it's on libraries, whether it's on human services, whether it's on our faith-based communities. And it's typical for party chairman in this case to talk about the impact that a decision has, whether it's a budget or some other piece of legislation, politically going forward. But I did not advocate, nor did I criticize any of the areas of the fundamental areas of the state revenue sources, including the budget revenue sources, including
just following up on that.
As you know, I've been a strong supporter of gambling in this state for many, many years, and will continue to be so on a personal level, and my record in the legislature reflects that.
Your wife is a lobbyist for me.
She is a very successful lobbyist, although she doesn't represent the Ohio Newspaper Association quite yet.
She is a lobbyist for Mountaineer Gaming. Did she ever discuss her client's interest in the VLT proposal with you?
With me? No, I don't think we had a conversation about whether or not I should or shouldn't advocate with anybody in the administration regarding Mountaineer Gaming. No. Now, do I discuss my wife's clients over a dinner table? Perhaps. I can't recall specifically an instance where that occurred. I would really suggest, though, Joe, I don't even know if you're married, but I would not think of asking you about what your wife does. I'd call your wife, and I encourage you, if you have any questions, to reach out to her.
Well, is it possible that you, through your wife, representation of Mountaineer, could profit from VLTs going into the racetrack?
Joe, I represent an area that's highly trafficked with travel and tourism. I own no stock in Cedar Point, but the governor just eroded most of the money in the travel and tourism budget that I used to press for every day. An increase in the local economy up on Lake Erie would mean less likelihood of reliance on property taxes, of which I pay, so I could profit from my support of travel and tourism industry. Whether my wife represents the Akron Civic Theater, which she has in the past, or St. Stephen's Church, which she has in the past, or Mountaineer Gaming, which she does today, will it impact my budget in terms of my personal resources? We don't have a joint checking account, so I can say no.
Well, could the VLTs represent a bonanza for Democratic candidates from the horse racing interests?
It's ironic, this focus on gambling. I recognize that it catches everyone's attention. I don't, again, dismiss or lessen. I just wonder where it was when David Brennan was handing out hundreds of thousands of dollars in campaign contributions with regard to charter schools. charter schools was written out of this budget by Ted Strickland and written back in by Bill Harris. I'm just curious where the consistency is. I don't want to be too defensive about this. The same thing with nursing home. If you were to add up the dollars that have been invested by the nursing home industry in political affairs in this state over the course of the last, in my case, 10 or 12 years, Republican versus Democrat, it is an eye-opener, an absolute eye-opener. And then, if you were to take the same argument with regard to ELTs that I'm suggesting with regard to nursing homes, I think it's 80% of the lobbyists representing the video lottery industry, the gambling industry, are Republicans.
The question still stands, though. Do you expect your party and its candidates to benefit from campaign contributions from horse racing tracks?
I would urge candidates seeking election or re-election to follow Governor Strickland's lead and state publicly that they will not accept contributions from gambling interests, or if they're opposed to charter schools, or Walmart, or any area that they are objecting to. The state party, however, does not take that stand. We do not say we will not accept money from the Farm Bureau versus the Farm Bureau, or lottery interests versus Methodist activists. We don't say to take that stand. It's far too a slippery slope for the state party to take.
Dollars he's already received.
I don't know that he has received any dollars. According to my conversations that I had with his finance people earlier this week, I was told that he's not received any direct contributions from the day he changed his opinion on video lottery terminals to today. I don't know of any dollars that have been received since that point. But when do we have the conversation about nursing homes, charter schools, hospitals, all of the other areas that you and I have seen grow exponentially over the course of the last decade, where we know that there are huge amounts of dollars being funneled into campaign accounts to support those who are willing to support those industries? I'm all for consistency. And if anyone in the legislature wants to lower the amount of money that can be invested in the campaign account, I would support it. Absolutely support it. And my voting record reflects that.
Chris, what do you think?